Good morning, students. In the previous video, we learned about past tense, and today we are going to learn about future tense. But before learning future tense, we must learn the uses of shall and will. Look at this chart. According to grammar rule, if subject is in first person, I and we, shall is used. Here are examples. I shall play football. We shall go to market. If subject is in second person, you, and third person, he, she, it, any name or they, will is used. Examples are, you will read a book, he will write a letter, they will wait for it. There are rules of grammar, or we can say it, normal future. Okay. But sometimes we want to express strong emotion about the future. It could be a promise, a command, or a determination for you. We call this strong future. Look at this chart. With I and we, in normal future, we use shall. And in strong future, we use will. With you, he, she, it, any name, or they, in normal future, we use will, and in strong future, we use shall. The grammar rules for strong future, we reverse will, shall. So now we are going to use will with the first person, I and we, and shall with the second and third person. Some examples are, I shall play football. I will get good marks in exam. Let us compare both sentences. The first sentence is, I shall play football. There is no emotion in first sentence. It is only a simple future arrangement. And second sentence is, I will get good marks in exam. In second sentence, we are showing strong determination. This is the strong future and we are using will. Sentence, we shall not work in the field. And fourth sentence is, we will not tolerate indiscipline in the school. In the first sentence, sorry, in the third sentence, there is no emotion. It is a just simple future arrangement. Fourth sentence is, we will not tolerate indiscipline in this. This sentence is showing warning, strong warning. That's why we have used will. So I and we were first person, and with them we have used will. Now we are going to use shall with second and third person. Look at these examples. First one is, you will read a book. In this sentence, we find that it is a simple future arrangement. And second one is, you shall finish your homework before you go to play. What type of sentence is this? This is a command order. A mother or a father can command or order his son or daughter and tell them that they shall finish their homework and go to play, not before. Another example is, he will not go to Ranchi. Again, this is simple future arrangement. Second line is, he shall not come to school. When we say he shall not come to school, he is determined not to come to school. Another example is, they will read a book. Again, this is simple future arrangement. Second one is, they shall wear proper uniform. In this sentence, we find that there is a strong rule, and that is why we have used shall here. Just now we have learnt about the uses of shall and will. Now let us proceed ahead and learn about the future tense. So future tense is also has been divided into four parts. First one is simple future tense. Second one is future continuous tense. Third one is future perfect tense. And fourth one is future perfect continuous tense. Now let us deal with them one by one. First one is simple future tense. And the rule of simple future tense is subject plus shall, will plus verb plus object. Examples are I shall cook food. Subject is I here, with I shall is used, verb is cooked, and object is food here. Other examples are you will bring fruits, they will drive a car. Second one is future continuous tense. And the rule of future continuous tense is subject plus shall, will plus be plus verb plus ing plus object. And examples are I shall be teaching English. She will be going to Delhi. They will be coming to your house. In the first sentence, subject is I. With I we use shall. Then shall be used here. Then verb plus ing is teaching here. Object is English here. Third one is future perfect tense. And the rule of future perfect tense is subject plus shall be plus have plus verb plus object. And examples are we shall have written a letter. You will have played hockey. He will have enjoyed the music. Look at the first sentence. Here subject is we. With we shall is used, have is here. The third form of the verb write is written. And object is here, a letter. And the fourth one is future perfect continuous tense. And the rule of future perfect continuous tense is subject plus shall be plus have plus been plus verb plus ing plus object. And examples are we shall have been drawing a picture. You will have been going to Ranchi. They will have been buying books. So in the first sentence, subject is we, with we shall is used, then have is here, denotes is here, verb plus ing is drawing, and object is a picture. Dear students, we have completed the topic tense completely. I hope you might have understood the topic. For you, my suggestion is, you must try to learn the rules of each tense and try to form sentences so that it will be very useful for you in the future. So thank you.